What's up, everybody? Caleb Dennison here with the Caleb Loves Tech YouTube channel. Oh, shit. Yep, great start. That is today, which I'll get into in a second here. But what was I saying? Ah, yes, day five of 365 videos. One video every day this year, as promised. Today was a challenge, and yeah, I'm going to talk about that in just a moment. For those of you who have followed me so far on this journey, I promised that there were going to be days where I had not that great videos. I do have some interesting stuff to say towards the end of this video, but this video is going to be about my day, a day that is not the kind of day that you wanna have the day before you get up super early in the morning to fly off for six grueling days of working my butt off at the world's largest tech show, CES, flying out tomorrow. And I have so much to do. I needed this day to go well, and it did not. It started with a 98-inch 8K TV delivery arriving far earlier than anyone should ever expect a TV delivery to arrive, first of all. And with absolutely no warning, I asked for a call ahead so that I could be ready for them. 98-inch TV, massive box, kind of a big ordeal to bring it into the studio, and got no call. Until they were here. And the next thing I know, a Sprinter van is rolling up and two dudes are loading this TV into the studio. What's crazy is that these guys drove in a Sprinter van for like a day and a half. They drove nonstop from New Jersey all the way across the country to Portland, Oregon to deliver this TV. Couldn't have gone FedEx. I mean, I understand you don't want to fly this thing on a plane. That would be ridiculously expensive, but they could have sent it like FedEx freight or UPS freight or something like that on a truck or a plane. No, two dudes, Sprinter van, drove all the way across the nation to deliver this TV, and they looked a little on the haggard side, but you know, that's what they do. And they got the TV in here. With that TV here, like, it couldn't just sit there in the box. There's not a lot of storage space here. Plus, as I'll tell you in a moment, we had other stuff coming in. So my buddy Greg came over and we went to unboxing this thing. And guys, this TV was not boxed well. It was not boxed for a secure transport. It was an absolute mess. It was missing a side piece of foam. It's a 98-inch TV. It's ridiculously heavy. It's very big. It's very unwieldy. It needs to be well protected. And it was missing a key critical piece of side foam. Anyway, we get the box open and the foam has just been battered. So now we've got pills of styrofoam just spraying everywhere, like a Willy water bug of foam pills going all over the studio, making an entire mess of the floor, which I still have yet to clean up. Shout out to anybody who remembers the Willy water bug. And if you don't, go look it up because it was the 80s sprinkler to play in, from my youth. Anyway, we got the TV unboxed. We managed to get the stand put together. We managed to get the things up on the BDI cabinet. And then I got three coffin-sized wood crates full of some really exciting stuff that's gonna support a project that we're gonna do when we get back from CES. But they're big, heavy wooden crates full of expensive stuff, and they can't be here. So we packed those up into the truck. My back is hating me for it now. Got those into the truck along with the massive Samsung box. Sent my buddy to Harbor Freight to get some bungee cords because we didn't have any bungee cords. And if we didn't, that box was just going to go flying out of the truck. So we had to get that secured. You know what? I'm a little parched. Would you give me a moment? This video is not sponsored by Sugar-Free Red Bull, by the way. Especially since half of it is in the carpet right now. It's that kind of day. So anyway, we got this stuff to the storage unit. We offloaded it. We came back. I had just enough time to eat some cold teriyaki chicken and rice. It was very dry. It was not pleasant, but it was food. So I got it in my face and then took off, drove 20 miles into Washington to watch my daughter's basketball game, which was amazing. It went into overtime. It was a super tight game, extremely entertaining, very exciting, very proud of my daughter. But overtime, of course, means that it ran long. Next thing I know, it's like 7:15 p.m. and I'm thinking, I have so much to do. I'm driving down the road, and then I'm like, you know what? If I'm gonna get an Instagram and a TikTok video out today, I just need to do it now. So I pulled off into, you know, it's suburbia, right? So it's one of these huge mall complexes. I pull off, get into the parking lot, park the truck, get out of the truck, and just start shooting right there. And as I'm shooting, I realize that I can smell it, right? There's a Popeye's chicken right behind me. You can go check out the Instagram and TikTok video that I posted today if you want to see what I'm talking about. Popeye's is right there, and the smell, it's just washing over me. And guys, I'm so hungry. That teriyaki chicken was such a huge disappointment. I'm so hungry. And guys, I love me some Popeye's, especially the mashed potatoes with Cajun gravy. I'm thinking maybe I'm gonna get myself a three-piece. Maybe I'm gonna get myself a spicy chicken sandwich. And then I realized, no, I can't do that. Because here's the deal, guys. Popeye's, it wrecks me. Like, if I were to have gotten that Popeye's and eaten it, I would have food in my belly right now, but I would also have a really unpleasant time tomorrow. And you know what else? You know who else would have a really unpleasant time? Everybody on the plane. And I'm not going to do that to people on the plane. I'm not that guy. I don't want to be that guy anyway. And so I'm not going to be that guy. I don't get the Popeye's, so I'm still hungry. Hence the freaking Red Bull that I spilled all over the place at the beginning of this video. That's just par for the course for the day. What are you gonna do? At any rate, I've got two loads of laundry to do, which takes about an hour and 15 minutes each. It's gonna be 2 hours start to finish for those two loads of laundry before I can even pack my bags. And I still need to go shopping. I still need to get stuff. All so that I can pack up and get on the plane to Vegas tomorrow. And you know what? I don't care. I don't care that it was a crap day, because I am so freaking, I'm so excited for tomorrow, you guys. I honestly think that this CES is going to be the most exciting CES in a decade, easily. I mean, the TVs are gonna be amazing. The computing stuff that's coming out is gonna be amazing. That's just the stuff I know about, right? There's gonna be surprises, I imagine. AI is gonna be everywhere. Robots, guys. Robots, so many robots. Robots that are doing things that robots probably don't need to do at all. But robots, like, let's get it. Let's get some robots up in here. And then, you know, all the smart home gadgets that are fun, if not at all practical, we'll see there. We are gonna see some stuff that we won't see anywhere else ever, because you know what? The only place you see it is at CES, and then it disappears and you never hear of it again. But there are people with dreams who are trying to make them a reality, and they're out there at CES and they're showing their stuff, and it's so cool and it's so exciting. And me and all my buds at Digital Trends get to go out there and report on it for you. It's awesome. You know what? So today sucked, but tomorrow starts something amazing. I'm gonna get 3 hours of sleep tonight. Probably go to bed at 1, get up at 4:30, and okay, so 3.5 hours of sleep. But, you know, I'm gonna arrive in Vegas tired, and I don't even care. I do not care, because I know from all the years that I've done this show in the past that as soon as I step foot out of that plane into the Las Vegas terminal and I smell the Vegas, you can smell the Vegas. The second you get off the plane, it just hits you. It smells like lost dreams and stale cigarette smoke and corn dogs. You know what I mean? And it's everywhere, right? It's everywhere. It's on the Strip. It's in every casino. It's in the Las Vegas Convention Center, when the Vegas Convention Center isn't smelling like poo, like literal actual poo. Because let me tell you guys, the bathrooms there get wrecked. It's not cute, speaking of wrecked. Anyway, it doesn't matter. As soon as all of that washes over me, instantly I'm gonna be energized. And you know what? All that means is that even though today's video kind of sucks, I know that tomorrow's videos are gonna be amazing. In fact, you know what? I'm probably gonna do two. I'll do two, because I'll do day 5 and day 5.5. Is today 4 or 5? I don't even know. I've lost count. I'll correct myself tomorrow. I don't care. Whatever it is, day 5, day 6, it'll be video 5 and 5.5, or video 6 and 6.5. It's going to be amazing. I cannot wait to take you there. Last thing I gotta say, guys, everybody who has subscribed to this channel and is watching this video and thinking, oh my God, what did I subscribe to? You subscribe to some awesome behind the scenes tech stuff, tech coverage, stuff you're not really gonna see anywhere else. how we do what we do at Digital Trends. I swear to God, the future videos are going to be awesome. I promise I'll make them awesome. Today was just one of those days where if I was going to make a video, I had to do this video right here. And I promised you guys I would keep it real. So here it is. It's real. But for everybody who subscribed, I owe you a huge thanks, an absolutely huge thanks. I do want to tease what's coming in a video tomorrow. Tomorrow, I'm going to tell you about a giveaway. We are going to be running a giveaway. Somebody I know, another YouTuber, reached out and offered something for giveaway. I'm ever so thankful for that. So tomorrow, I'm announcing a giveaway to celebrate our 5,000 subscriber milestone, which we absolutely blasted through. As I'm recording this, we're already up to, I think, 7,500, which means 10K is on the way. And I already have to start thinking about what's the 10K giveaway gonna be. I don't know, but we're gonna figure it out. Maybe I'll score something at CES. I have no idea. Anyway, guys, stick with me. Thank you for subscribing. Stick with me. I promise I'm gonna make some amazing content for you. I hope that you got something out of this video. If nothing else, you understand the kind of mania that happens before a show like CES. But what you're gonna get over the next few days is going to be awesome. I'm gonna make it worth your while. I absolutely promise you. I will see you on tomorrow's video. And until then, peace.